Gentlemen, imagine for a minute you and your wife just purchased your first home. Now that you have your first house, what are you going to do with it? Decorate. Now you two sit down, try to figure out how you want to decorate it. Your wife says, I think we should make our entire house bright pink. You say, honey, I don't think that's a good idea. And she says, what do you know about the interior decorating? Well, hopefully, by the end of today, you'll all be experts on interior decorating. It may be hard to believe, but interior decorating is one of our greatest pastimes. Once you get started, it's very hard to stop. There are so many styles to choose from, such as Mediterranean, Italian, Oriental, and many others. But for today, we're just going to cover the basics, how to use color, textures, patterns, and furniture to personalize your house any way you want it. We're going to start off with colors. When you're picking color schemes for your house, you want to use an interior designer's best friend, the color wheel. The color wheel is made up of red, yellow, and blue, the three primary colors, and mixtures of those three colors. Now, in picking your schemes, we're going to use four different color schemes today. We're going to use monochromatic color schemes, harmonious color schemes, complementary, and triadic color schemes. First off, a monochromatic color scheme is a color scheme where you decorate your house with one color and use different shades and tones of that color all over your house. That's an example. Notice how it has dark green, light green, but everything is green. Next up is harmonious. Harmonious uses three colors that are right next to each other on the color wheel. Notice how this room starts off with the darkest color on the floor, the second darkest on the tiles next to the floor, and the lightest on the top. That's because if you had like dark, light, and then medium, it would kind of be a little too sporadic and people would be a little confused walking in the room. But this way it starts very warm from the bottom up. Next up, my favorite, complementary. Complementary is made up by choosing two colors that are direct opposites on the color wheel, or you can use split complementary where you choose a color, then go to the opposite side of the color wheel and use two colors that are on the opposite sides of its complement. The trick behind complementary colors is that if you use two colors in equal distribution, it'll be way too much going on in one room. So as we did here, we used red and green that are opposites. We used mainly red, but we used green to kind of spice it up. But you don't want to have them trying to overpower each other. The triadic color scheme, you use three colors that are equally spaced out on the color wheel. Again, like with complementary, you don't want the colors battling for attention. So in this room, we started off with a neutral white on the walls, and we used yellow, red, and blue, all just to be decorations. And now that we're done with colors, you want to learn how to use textures to finish up the room. Textures are great for adding luxury, substance, and interest to a room. You want to use them when you have a single-colored room, not like monochromatic, like one-colored room that seems way too plain. With textures, you want to use rough textures and soft textures. And you want to mix them equally. You don't want to have them on opposite sides of the room, but you must make sure not to overdo it. You can use shiny and glossy textures to make your room look more sophisticated, but don't use too many. Similar to textures, you can use patterns to make your room bold, interesting, and unique. Patterns can be used with the same pattern in different colors. Make sure when you're using your patterns, you start on a wall or a curtain or somewhere. The trick on patterns is to use bold patterns in small areas. Here we use a plain pattern, which is the bricks of different colors all over the wall. And then the real trick here is to try to match your furniture with solid colors from the patterns. You can't really see it here, but all the furniture matches one of the brick colors on the wall. Use a small pattern in a small area on the pillars. You want to use large patterns in large areas, small patterns in small areas. If you use small patterns in a large area, it looks way too fussy. Now that you know how to use texture, colors, and patterns, let's look at how to use furniture. The absolute key with planning your furniture, using your furniture, is planning ahead of time. Draw out your room, make yourself some little cards with what you think your furniture looks like in size and scale compared to your room, and try to figure it out from a bird's eye view how you want it to look. Make sure you plan out where sockets are and where the jumps in and out of your room are. Look how this room here, it looks very nice with the way they use the furniture, but the error they made was they put all the furniture on the outside of the room, making it look way too clinical. You want to try to keep your furniture spread avoided from this because it makes it feel very unwelcome. But also notice how they try to keep the same colors. They use a black couch, black TV, and then on the other side of the room they use a wooden color. When you have large rooms, use dark, bold furniture as they did here. And when you have small rooms, you want to use light colored furniture with dark walls. Now in review, looking at what we've learned how to use colors, how to pick colors for your house, how to use textures and patterns to add personality to your house, and how to plan out how to use your furniture in your house. Now just remember to follow these simple guidelines, and you'll all hit the ground running when it comes to decorating your first house.